getting into this men's 3 meter springboard final as they await the third of six optional dives from Mark Lindsay of the United States.
Now Mark is doing reverse, 2.5 pike. It was his worst dive of the preliminaries. And I'm getting a little nervous watching this because he's been bringing it a little too close to the board. If he is too close, he will have to hold on and probably take the dive over. And actually, he overcompensated. He jumped out too far and held the dive short. His coach, Hobie Billingsley, who came out of retirement to coach him, looking on. There he starts to move away. He does take it up high. Again, he's spinning quite slowly. That's the same mistake he made in the last round on the back 2.5. There's his coach watching and going through the whole dive with him.
And the marks for Mark Lindsay, a low of 6.5 and a high of 7.5 for a total of 62.10. He will not be happy with that one. The seventh of the 12 divers in the competition, Andreas Vels of Germany.
And he had some trouble in the last round on his front 3.5 pike. This is back 2.5 pike. He has long legs. It makes it difficult to spin in pike. He needs to swing hard with his arms. And that was a very good dive. It wasn't as clean on the bottom, nor did it finish as high as we like to see it, or do see it finish with some of the divers that are ranked higher. He has those long legs. He has to squeeze tight into his pike, and he does get around far enough, but he kicks over a little bit on the bottom.
Knock off the high score and the low, add the rest and multiply by the degree of difficulty, and that gives you the 67.50 that Vels earned on the dive. Here's the bronze medalist on 3 meter in Spain, Dmitry Sauten, a 22-year-old Russian.
And a little bit of a rocky start so far. Had trouble on both his first two dives, only scoring around sevens, which is uncharacteristic of him. This is back 2.5 pike. It is an excellent dive for him. We want to see him put it away. And that was very good. It's not going to get great scores because it moves slightly by on the bottom. This is what distance does. He takes it out too far. There's a little crimp in the knees, meaning a little bit of a bend, and the dive goes over. When you go back too far and spin backwards, you have control problems, and that's what he had there.
Well, the judges didn't find that much wrong with it. Kathy Seaman is the Canadian judge, and she gave Dmitry an 8.5. The second American in the final. There are no Canadians competing in the final. This is Scott Doty of the United States, second on 10 meter in Spain. He's come down to compete springboard here in Atlanta.
And he has been one of the most consistent competitors in the meet. This is front 3.5 pike. His only problem is that he doesn't jump as high as the rest of the field. And that was another example of his consistent diving. He doesn't seem to be able to make any splash. He has such clean entries, consistently clean entries. It almost seems that he could land flat and still rip the entry. That's a tight pike, and he reaches to the bottom, and he brings all the water down with him.
Well, the crowd would have liked higher scores, a low of 7.5, a high of 8.5 for Scott Doty of the U.S. This is Michael Murphy, 22-year-old from Australia, who was fourth in Spain on 3 meter and picked up the Commonwealth gold in Victoria on the same board.
And a lot of people think that he could walk away with a medal from these Olympics. This is a back 2.5 pike. He is a rhythmic diver. He is a beautiful diver. And he needs a clean entry here. And that was a good dive. Pulls it through a little bit on the bottom. His main weakness is that he's a little bit loose in the midsection, and that gives him problem on his entries. It was a pretty good takeoff. That is good distance. The trajectory is everything. And as you see the arch in his back when he goes in the water, that's a problem.
Came into the dive in sixth position and moves up to third for the time being. Gets 3/8, 7.5. 6.5 and 7 for a total of 68.40. This is Yu Zhongcheng from China. 20-year-old, 3-meter and 1-meter specialist, the world champion on 3-meter in 94 in Rome.
And he put this dive into his list solely for the finals. We'll see if it pays off. I think it will. Reverse, 3.5. That's one of the highest degree of difficulty dives in the competition. He did not use it in the prelims. He set his whole list up strategically to prepare for this dive. He's got a great tuck. The only thing is his feet are flat. We'll see if they deduct for that, but that's a very, very good dive. He will score high, and he will get a lot of points because the degree of difficulty is very high. That's a knee save underwater to make it look like it goes straight in.
Eights, 8.5s, including an 8 from Kathy Seaman of Canada. Right now, let's go to the track and join Don Whitman.
Floor exercises. Scott?
Thanks very much, Brian. And